So I now like to bring out your next psychic, I guess. He's a futurist and a psychic, and his name is the Incredible Blasco. Everyone, give it up for the Incredible Blasco.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am the Incredible Blasco. I have seen into our amazing future, and tonight I will astound you with predictions about the glorious utopia that awaits us in our amazing future. Better. Best. My friends, I predict that in our amazing future, television shows and movies will be broadcast directly into our brains. We'll be able to watch them anytime we want, on the train, in the office, while our wives drone on to us about who brought what to the winter bake sale or whatever damn club they belong to, right, guys? We won't have to listen to any of that crap in the future. No way. You'll never guess who Eleanor Lamont got to redo their sunroom. Our words we will simply not hear in the incredible future. Because we will be watching TV in our brains. We'll be watching The 2.5 Men of Tomorrow, which I predict will be even more hilarious than The 2.5 Men of today. My friends, I predict that the cars of tomorrow will self-navigate through the air, and that men will feel free to buy whatever kind of car they want, no matter how expensive or impractical it may be, without being cruelly mocked by their wives for having a midlife crisis. Who are you trying to impress? You're pathetic. Are words that we simply will not hear in our amazing future. Along with the kinds of women who are attracted to cars like these don't want scrawny old men like you. You wouldn't know what to do with them if they were interested. We won't hear that. We just won't hear it in the future. Attitudes will change. I predict that in our amazing future, all disagreements between all people will be settled by a device called the Resolutor. Marital disputes will be a thing of the past, and our wives will have no reason to embarrass us at cocktail parties with their temper tantrums and their tearful displays, constantly obsessing over minor transgressions we may commit in the future. Transgressions that they, by the way, will drive us to with their grating behavior and refusal to take care of their bodies. I predict that in our amazing future, extramarital affairs will be commonplace. They will be expected of men and women, particularly men. Yes, my friends, the wives of the future will be angry if their husbands do not sleep with another woman on a recent speaking engagement in Seattle. And then give that other woman the home phone number instead of the cell phone. She calls and leave a rather explicit message on the home machine, and the wife hears it. The wives of tomorrow will be angry if that doesn't happen. As opposed to today, when it's, you know, a betrayal and unforgivable and blah, blah, blah. My friends, I predict that in our amazing future, women will admit that they only cry to manipulate us, and they will stop it. They won't do it anymore. I further predict that marriage counseling will be available in pill form. And no more men will be dragged to it, only to face baseless accusations of making a pass at the counselor. Accusations which are then backed up by the counselor in an incredibly unprofessional display of a lack of objectivity. Not to mention a lapse in patient-doctor confidentiality. Completely. My friends, I predict
that in our amazing future, we won't have all these hang-ups about sex that you see today, man. No, in the future, birthday parties and holidays will be celebrated not with cake and singing and presents, but with orgies. Orgies of sex. And men who propose that their birthdays be celebrated in that way because they met a guy at the post office who belongs to a club that gets together and has orgies and happens to be looking for more members right now. Men who come home and say, that's what I want to do for my birthday, will not be called perverts by their uptight wives. Because there will be no uptight wives in the future. They will all be dead. And if there is maybe one left, they'd probably put her in a zoo. And gawk at her and say, wow, thank God it's now. I wouldn't want to have been alive when they roamed the earth. My friends, I predict that in our amazing future, society will redefine male attractiveness. It will no longer be necessary to be the tallest or the most muscular. No, the much smarter women of the future will prize other traits, such as a nasally voice and an ability to see into the future. Men who can see into the future will get all the action they can handle in the future. I further predict that our species will evolve to the point where we have no inhibitions whatsoever. We will only wear clothes when it is very, very cold, and even then our clothes will be transparent, so that everyone can see our beautiful genitals and breasts. No one will react with shock and anger when we show them our genitals. No, no, not like today. And if we see a set of genitals or breasts that we want to touch, we will simply reach out and touch them without fear or shame. In the future, the word sexual and harassment will never appear in the same sentence. And it certainly won't be possible to fire someone from their job at Staples for committing that. Because it won't be a thing you can commit. My friends, I predict that in our amazing future, women who have been given a drug that renders them unconscious will be delighted to wake up and find that they have been made love to. And they will be thankful for the good night's sleep. Finally, my friends, I predict that in the future there will be no police to arrest people for simply following their natural biological instincts. Today, people who are accused of a crime are ostracized by the community, but in the future, it will be the accusers who will get strange looks at the Staples of the future, which will carry office supplies that we can hardly imagine today. Such as mind-controlled three-hole punchers and three-sided tape. Finally, for real this time, my friend. I predict that in our amazing future, just a few moments from now, in fact, I will be in the bathroom of this very establishment. I will be joined there by a beautiful blonde woman, possibly a redhead. And if a few minutes go by and neither one of those goes in, a brunette would be fine. No offense, but Asians need not apply. Anyway. What happens after that? Well, if you want to know that, you'll just have to wait for our amazing future. I will see you there. Good night!